English we speak.
From BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to the English we speak. I'm Neil and joining me in this programme is Feifei.
Hi.
Beautiful day today, isn't it? Blazing sunshine. Oh, it's so warm.
Yes, it is. And luckily for you, your shift is finished after this programme, isn't it?
Yep, but you have to stay here till evening on the late shift. Ah, I'm off to the park to enjoy the sun. I'd better buy some sun cream, hey?
Don't rub it in.
Ah, okay. See you later.
2 hours later.
My word, Neil, what's happened to you? You look like a lobster.
It's very hot and sunny out there.
But what about the sun cream?
You told me not to rub it in, Feifei.
Okay, I think I need to explain something. We use the expression to rub something in when a person keeps mentioning something another person wants to forget. When I said, don't rub it in, I was fed up of hearing about your wonderful afternoon in the sun while I'm stuck here in the office.
Ah, so I actually should have rubbed in this sun cream. Let's hear some examples.
Don't rub it in. I know you beat me at tennis, but you don't have to keep mentioning the score.
Carlos got into Oxford, but I didn't. That's bad enough, but he keeps rubbing it in by talking about it all the time.
This is the English we speak, and in this programme we're learning the phrase to rub it in. If a person rubs it in, it means they keep mentioning something another person wants to forget.
I want to forget that I've got such a terrible sunburn.
Well, I won't rub it in and talk about that sun cream you should have...
Should have rubbed in. Thanks, Feifei. Ouch.
Bye.
Bye.
The English we speak.
From bbclearningenglish.com.